Alrighty then, let's talk about Los Angeles Clippers rumors that they can move Lewis Williams. Let's talk about it. Hit that subscribe button, bell icon button. Check out our NBA Talk playlist for more videos like this. And my whole thing is this about Lewis Williams and the Clippers. Now, the Montrezl Harrell said the Clippers didn't want him back. Possibly the Clippers didn't want him back because they haven't said anything publicly. He got $9 million a year for 2 years, $18 million, to play for the Lakers, which, in my opinion, I think they're playing Harrell under the table. Just my opinion on that, all right? Just pure speculation. But it looked like that the Clippers could be getting rid of the dudes who didn't produce in the offseason. You know what I'm saying? I mean, in the bubble. And I think it's a little too brash to do so because the bubble wasn't real basketball. So I think they should give Lewis Williams another chance. But then again, who you going to trade Lewis Williams for? That's the question. And I think this kind of gives some validity to that the older Clippers were clashing with Paul George and Kawhi Leonard because they got special treatment. And it seems that Steve Ballmer and Jerry West is going to get rid of the Clippers that basically were of yesterday. They got rid of Doc Rivers. They got rid of Montrezl Harrell, basically. And they've been talking about trading Lewis Williams. There was some talk that he could have get flipped for the 18th pick and go to the Dallas Mavericks. But me personally, he didn't play well in the bubble. You know, he ended up going to Magic City, eating lemon pepper wings. That's why they call him Lemon Pepper Blue. And, you know, personally, remember, the Clippers could lose Paul George and Kawhi Leonard next year, one-on-one deals. So, honestly, I think they're doing the right thing. They're making Paul George Kawhi happy. But my whole thing is, they just ain't done enough. If I trade Lewis Williams, I'm going to probably trade him to the Knicks and try to get Mitchell Robinson and Dennis Smith Jr., maybe Kevin Knox, something like that. They need to fill out that roster. And I don't think you need a super team to reign supreme. You just need the right team. You got two stars on the wing, Kawhi Leonard and Paul George. If nothing, they're going to defend. You know, really, you need a guy, you know, that's going to be the point guard. Who going to run the show? You can give Dennis Smith Jr. a try. You know, you can go out there and look for other point. Aaron Holiday for the Indiana Pacers. He may be young, but he might be ready. You know, there's options out there. They just got to just peel through the bull ties. And that's the thing. There's point guards out there to run the show. Patty Mills, DeJounte Murray. You know, there's guys out there. But, I mean, until they trade Lewis Williams, I believe it. You know, Lewis Williams didn't play well in the bubble. But it's hard to get a rhythm when you've been quarantined for 10 or 14 days. You know, and then you get into a regular season, you can't get a rhythm. Had Lewis Williams and Montrezl Harrell carried their production over from the season to the bubble, they would have easily won the championship. But they didn't. That's what made the Clippers spectacular. Is that Lewis Williams and Montrezl Harrell production off the bench give them a boost that nobody in the National Basketball Association had. But my thing for them losing Montrezl Harrell for nothing, I just don't know where the talent going to come from unless you flip Kawhi Leonard or Paul George. So you still got Patrick Beverley. I mean, they got Luke Kennard. I forgot about him from the Pistons. You know, I don't know what they're barking at. I apologize. But, they've been saying they're going to trade Lewis Williams for so long now. I don't even know if I believe it no more. So what they lineup could look like next year, Patrick Beverley, Luke Kennard, Paul George, Kawhi on the wings, and then Ibaka in the middle. I don't think Ibaka is enough. You know, I think, man, they need to let me run the Clippers. No disrespect to Jerry West. I'll be going to Orlando, get Mo Bamba, and some of them guys over there. That's what I would be doing, but maybe the Clippers got a plan. But I don't know if I trade Lewis Williams just for a bad bubble performance. The bubble don't even count. To me, that wasn't a real championship. But they were saying that Montrezl Harrell was a double agent, and that proved to be true with them not bringing him back. But, you know, if you're trading Lewis Williams, man, you better get two or three players in return. But I still don't think the Clippers are good enough to dominate, and I still don't think the Lakers are good enough to dominate. I really think Denver is a team that they can develop their young stars. You know, they can be a problem. I would say Dallas, but Porzingis ain't never healthy, you know, and that's the issue. But I like Lewis Williams, good ball player. I think they should keep him. But to be honest, I don't think the Clippers are good enough to dominate a playoff run, even in a situation where they go into arena with limited fans. But hey, let me know what you guys think. Don't forget me on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. Reach out if you have a business question, inquiry, sponsorship, video quest, all my social media links, description. I also got a Facebook group. Twitter's the fastest way if you want to reach out and, you know, do some business or advertise on the channel. Want to make a financial donation, Cash App, CJ Good 313. That's in the description, PayPal link there as well, too. Appreciate the love and support. Best way to donate, share the video, hit that subscribe button, bell icon button. Appreciate it. And let me know what you guys think about the Lou Williams trade rumors. We gone.